My name is Mr. McCarthy Tambaya, a staff of Nigerian Korean Model School. I'm here to speak on a subject matter, developing and using multimedia as supplementary teaching materials for model education. And under this topic, I'm going to consider in ICT a topic, computer related devices or machine. But before I go further, let me put everything in rhythm. The topic says developing and using multimedia as supplementary teaching materials for model education. Developing multimedia and using as a supplementary teaching material for model education. In this context, I'm going to consider a topic that I'm going to teach in ICT, computer or electronic devices. Electronic devices, those devices that are related to computer. What are electronic devices? Electronic devices are machines or devices that cannot function without the power supply. For instance, this handset or smartphone is an example of electronic devices. Once if this handset or smartphone, if there is no power or if it's not charged, this handset cannot function. Similarly, we have other examples of electronic devices like the desktop computer is an example of electronic devices like the laptop. For instance, this laptop is an example of electronic devices like the digital camera. It's an example of electronic devices. We have a lot of them. For the purpose of this discussion, I will just limit myself with these examples. Let me go back to the topic, developing multimedia and using as supplementary material teaching for model education. What does this topic connote? It is very expedient for us to understand this concept. We are talking about developing and using multimedia as supplementary teaching material for model education. What does this connote? In a nutshell, we are talking about the way we can use multimedia to enhance our teaching and learning effectively and efficiently. But in a situation where, in the absence of these multimedia gadgets, if they are not available, what will be the rationale behind that you can augment, to supplement, to ensure that the learning, teaching and learning have taken place in a suitable manner or in effective and efficient way? For you to achieve this, if you don't have the multimedia gadget in your disposal as a resource person, what is expected for you is that you improvise the related materials that will augment those multimedia or digital forms of information that you use to teach in a class when you are using multimedia. In the absence of those multimedia gadgets, you are supposed to look for a supplement. You are supposed to look for something that will substitute those things, that will make your teaching and learning to be explicit to your learners. And those things that you are supposed to put into considerations in the absence of multimedia gadgets or multimedia materials in your disposal, as a teacher or a resource person, you need to think outside your box to look for other things, materials that will enable you to make your learning objective to be achieved. And what are those things that you use in order to make your learning objective to be achieved? For instance, in the absence of these materials, you can look for and make use of text, graphics, pictures, sound of audios. You can use maps, you can use graphics, you can use so many other things to ensure that your learning and teaching is effective. E.g., as I've said, pictures, maps, diagram, and so on and so forth. As I'm talking about the electronic devices, by the time that if I don't have those things in my disposal, I will use charts. I will draw. Use cardboard paper to draw the picture of the handset. I will show it to the learners in the class. By the time that if I show them that this in the picture of that this handset or smartphone, it will make them not to forget in time. The picture that they have seen, what they have seen, they have touched, it will stick in their brain. Similarly, if I don't have laptop in my disposal that I'm holding, this laptop. So in this situation, if I don't have laptop as an example of an example of electronic machine to present to the learners, what I will do is that I will go online to print charts, printed chart pictures of different sample of laptops of different shape, of different sizes. I'll print it and bring it to them in the class to see it vividly. It's something that is tangible that they will view, they can see. By the time that when they see it, those pictures, it will stick in their memory. Their cognitive thinking will be enhanced because it will be very hardly for them to forget those pictures that they have seen. So you have supplemented, that picture have supplemented the multimedia that you are supposed to use. So as a resource person or a teacher, you need to be resourceful and dynamic in your teaching. You're supposed to improvise in the absence of a particular thing that you want to teach. If you don't have it in your disposal, you are supposed to improvise. So that printed charts have supplements the multimedia that you're supposed to present to the children in the class. The charts that you have printed, the pictures that you have printed, it has substituted the whole thing. So in this scenario, you can use those materials. You can even ask them to go and draw as their home task. You can ask them to go and draw. Maybe they should draw a monitor, because we are talking about electronic machines that are related to the computer devices. You can ask them to go and draw a laptop or monitor or CPU in the desktop, or you can ask them to draw a handset or smartphone. You can even ask them to draw gadget like camera. So all those things, by the time that when they use their manipulative skill to draw those things, they will not forget what they have done by themselves. And anytime if somebody asks them, what are the examples of electronic devices, they will never forget it. And the aim of that topic will be achieved, of teaching that topic will be achieved. So, in a nutshell, the importance of using supplementary material in teaching and learning in the absence of multimedia cannot be overemphasized. One, when you are using supplementary material in teaching of multimedia, it makes the learners to be creative. It will make them to be resourceful. Even you, the resource person, it makes you to be resourceful because it will make you to think outside your comfort zone. By the time that if you have a particular topic to teach, it will make you to be proactive in where you go and look for supplementary material that you will deliver your lesson to your learners without any complaint. You must not say that until I have this multimedia material before I present my lesson. In the absence of those multimedia gadgets, you are going to improvise. So it's very, very important. It makes you to be creative. It makes you to think very well. It will enable you to rack your brain to look for the possible solutions, ways that you will make your provision to supplement, to augment something that you are going to present to your learners. And similarly, when you are using supplementary material, it will make you sometimes to engage the learners at all the time, because all the time you'll be giving them home tasks. There are something that you want to teach, maybe next week, this week, you even give them a home task to go and prepare about it. If it has to do with pictures or diagrams, they will go and draw it. Those that know how to draw very well, they will bring it to the class. You can use it as your teaching material. By the time that you are going to present your lesson, you can select some people that know how to draw, some learners that know how to draw very well. You select them, you give them to go and draw it. And you too, it will make you to pick the challenge, even if you don't know how to draw, to enhance your creativity in drawing. By the time that when you are giving them such type of work, it will make them to collaborate. They will stay together, they will brainstorm, they will discuss issues. If somebody make his drawing to look attractive than the other one will start asking him questions. How do you draw it? How do you make this work? How do you make it? He will ask his partner and he can put him through. And by the time that when you are using all these materials, pictures, diagrams, to supplement in your teaching, it will make the teaching and learning to be less boring. Everything is going to be explicit, because anything you are presenting to them with illustration, with pictures and charts, with diagrams, they will comprehend easily than talking without showing any concrete material to them. So it makes the learning and teaching and learning to be very sweet. Because when you are using this kind of materials, pictures, they are tangible pictures. It's not that you are talking as a fiction. It's something that they are seeing in a real sense. So it's not fiction. It's something that is tangible, something that they can touch, they can see, they can feel. So it remains stick in their brain. So in a nutshell, the importance of using supplementary material to augment multimedia material in teaching and learning cannot be overemphasized. Thank you.